Full house. Yeah. Good evening, family and friends, and welcome to this celebration of marriage. Chelsea and Nathan would like to thank you for joining them this evening as they declare their marriage vows and embark on a journey of commitment and love. They'd like to especially thank everyone who has traveled to be part of this celebration. Chelsea and Nathan are thrilled that so many of their friends and family members are here, because having you all here this evening for this momentous event is really the most important part of this day. They're so happy to share this moment with you as they join their lives in marriage. As you all know, Chicago means so much to Chelsea and Nathan. They may currently reside in Colorado, but family and friends are still here in this beautiful city where the bride and groom grew up. Chicago is where they first lived together. They began their careers here, and of course, they became engaged here. So it was very important to them both that they celebrate their marriage in the city that holds such a special place in their hearts. Before we begin, we want to acknowledge all of those very special people who could not be here this evening to celebrate this beautiful event with us. Chelsea and Nathan know that their love is always surrounding them, and they hold these loved ones forever in their hearts. This evening is a celebration of love and commitment, of friendship and family. In the presence of all of you, Chelsea and Nathan are here to take their vows as a married couple. At this time, I'd like to ask Chelsea's Aunt Sue to come up to recite one of the seven blessings, the Shevra Brachot, which is traditionally performed in its entirety at a Jewish wedding ceremony. Big smile, right? Chelsea and Nathan chose to include this reading to honor Chelsea's Jewish cultural background.
Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher barach sason b'simcha, chatan b'chol, gila, rina, dina, v'chedva, ahava v'achava, v'shalom v're'ut, mehura Adonai Eloheinu. Yishma Barei Yehuda Uvhutzot Yerushalmi Kol Sason V'Kol Simcha Kol Hatan V'Kol Chala Kol Mitzhalot Chatani Mechupatam Unorim Mimishte Neginatam Baruch Atah Adonai Misameach Chatan Im Chakala.
I may have slightly messed up that pronunciation.
No,
It was pretty good, but who knows? Thankfully, I don't have to do an Irish brogue when I ask Nathan's Aunt Mary to come up to read an Irish blessing. Mary delivered a very similar blessing to Nathan and Chelsea at Nathan's family home after Nathan and Chelsea were engaged. It's a beautiful memory that will stay with them forever.
May you live a long life full of gladness and health, with a pocket full of gold to be the least of your wealth. May the dreams that you both hold dearest be those which come true, and the kindness that you both spread keep returning to you.
Thank you, Sue and Mary. Very beautiful passages. Marriage is one of life's most joyful occasions. We have thousands of important moments that happen throughout our lives, but marriage is regarded as one so significant, we acknowledge its special status by sharing it so publicly with others, because despite all of our cultural, generational, and societal differences, love is all we really share. It's the great unifier. We've all loved in our lifetimes. Some of our stories are shorter than others. Some are yet unwritten. And some are just getting to the good part. We all have chapters in our love stories that are sad and disappointing, and others that are exciting and full of adventure. We're all here tonight because we want those moments for you, Chelsea and Nate. We're here tonight to hope with you, to support you, to remind you that love is the experience of writing your own story. It's not one moment, it's every moment. It's big ones like saying I love you and moving in together and getting engaged. But it's mostly a million little ones that come in between all of those big moments. Making dinner together, spending holidays with your families, binge watching Netflix shows, and getting a big hug when you get home from a tough day at work. These everyday moments fuse together into one big experience. And though we try to describe and explain the experience of love, we all know it simply when we see it. And we see it here tonight. Over the past several months, I've had the opportunity to speak with Chelsea and Nathan to learn more about how we've all ended up here tonight. I spoke with them as a couple on many occasions and spoke with each of them individually at length. And there really is so much to say, and I will try to be brief, but that's not easy for an Italian guy. So I'll start from the beginning. I learned the details of how they met while training for and riding the Little 500. And for those of you not in the know, think the Indianapolis 500, but you know, the college student drunken version, I imagine. Anyway, and soon after that, there was the Hilly 500, the Hilly 100 rather. And you'd think by this time, these two would be completely exhausted, but nope. It was Chelsea semi-formal. And that happened to fall on the same night as Nate's 21st birthday. So what's a girl to do? Take him out for his first legal drink at a popular college bar, of course, right? And finally experience their first kiss. Since that night, Chelsea and Nathan have shared so many beautiful moments that speak of their love and respect for one another. I heard about the night that Nathan waited in the freezing cold at the bus stop for Chelsea to return to school after a family vacation, all smiles and so happy to see her. They told me about sitting on the porch swing at Chelsea's sorority after dinner one evening when Nathan said those three powerful little words. I learned of their adventure in driving back and forth between Chicago and Bloomington to move Chelsea into her apartment. They told me that they had date night watching Game of Thrones on their laptops while Nathan was finishing school and Chelsea was in Chicago, thereby creating their own version of modern love. And of course, there were megabus experiences between Chicago and Indianapolis during their long-distance courtship, because as Nathan said, you make the effort when you know you have a really, really good thing going on. These days, Chelsea and Nathan enjoy their time together, biking and hiking and cooking and traveling, and just being with family and friends, solidifying those new and old relationships. And while they are different people inherently, they share in common a desire to listen and try to understand the other's needs, thoughts and ideas, points of view. I learned in these conversations that Chelsea and Nathan really, really complement each other very well. And they work so well together because they're friends, first and foremost. On separate occasions, I heard from both of them the words, hands down, my best friend. They can simply be who they are at their core with one another, and they both feel 100% themselves when they're together. This may be a little over the top, but I'm going to admit that after these conversations with Chelsea and Nathan, I more than once was choked up reflecting on our discussions. And thinking about the promise that their love and commitment held, that they were capable of anything because of their shared commitment to making one another the priority in their world. And if that isn't enough to guide you, Chelsea and Nathan, well, you've received some indispensable, very sage advice from family and friends that you can always fall back on. Advice such as, like a fine wine, marriage simply gets better with age. And of course, never go to bed angry with each other. I've heard the stories of Chelsea's grandparents, Barbara and Myron Weiss, who never went to bed angry with one another because she always made him apologize first. It's one way to do it, right? Someone suggested that you laugh with each other daily, communicate clearly, openly, honestly, and constantly. And my first personal favorite is never be afraid to solve your arguments with ice cream. Chelsea and Nathan, you fell in love by chance, and you're here today because you're making a choice. You've chosen to be with someone who enhances you, makes you smile, makes you think, and simply makes your day brighter. You're choosing each other, and you're about to make promises to each other that you intend to keep. You're going to vow to take care of each other, to stand up for one another, and to find happiness in the other. There's a common thread to each of these promises. You're vowing to be there. You've chosen to write your own vows, and with these words, you'll express your binding promises of love, honor, and to cherish one another. If you're ready to make these promises, then I invite you now to declare your intentions. I have these little things that might help you. Here, one there. Chelsea, please begin when you're ready.
Nate, you are my best friend, my soulmate. And I can't tell you how happy I am to be standing up here today marrying my person. You are the one person in the whole world that I'm 100% myself with, because I know that no matter what, you will stand by me. Even when I'm goofy, difficult, awkward, messy, a overly sensitive. I know that I can be that with you because you will love me and support me. Because I know you love me completely. Our relationship is not perfect. We work at it every day, and I know what that's what makes it so strong. More than that, I know that is what is going to make it last for the years ahead, through the adventures and the exciting times, but also through the difficult times. Nate, you are the most kind, thoughtful, funny, loyal, patient, and genuine person I know. I am a better person because I have you in my life. And it is because of that I make these promises to you today. I promise to be your forever adventure buddy, to see the world and create new memories together because the world is a more fun place with you by my side. I promise to be your partner and teammate, to make decisions and grow together no matter where life takes us. I promise to laugh at your jokes. The funny ones. And also the ones that are so dumb that I can't help but smile. I promise to support your dreams and help you build them as your sounding board and confidant. I promise to work hard to make each day better than the last, even tomorrow, which is going to be pretty tough because this day has already been so perfect. Most importantly, Nate, I promise to love you completely. Just as I've done since the day we first said those three words. I love you, and I cannot wait to be your wife.
Tough act to follow. Wow.
You ready?
I think so. Yeah.
Let's do it.
Oof. Can I have a couple more minutes to...
You need to revise
something? Yeah. Don't go anywhere. Chelsea. How surreal it is to be standing here with you today in front of our friends and family, taking this brief moment to reflect on our time together, open our hearts, and to look to the future. Our relationship and the memories we have made together have become interwoven with who I am and how I define myself. Today is a testament to the love we have created and a glimpse into the future that we have in front of us. Looking at our friends and family gathered here today, I have no doubts that our love is special, and I am confident that it will stand the test of time. You are an amazing woman with incredible drive and determination. You have a kind heart and a warm soul, and I am constantly learning from you. Where I am weak, you are strong, and I will always do my best to give you the love and devotion you deserve. You are my best friend and my partner in all endeavors, big and small. Every single moment we have together is beautiful and a gift, and I treasure all of those little moments that make our relationship unique. I look forward to each new day together and each new adventure that we will embark on. The next mountain we will climb, the next mountain we will ski down, the next city we will explore, the next lazy Sunday we will spend doing nothing, and of course, the next challenge we will overcome together. As you know, there are many things in life that worry me and give me doubt. Sometimes it's the big things, like moving across the country or thinking about the unknown. Other times it's the even bigger things, like making a phone call or interacting with a stranger. But as long as I have you, I know I will never be afraid. I know with you by my side, with your never-ending love and support, there is nothing I cannot do. Chelsea, I promise to cherish you and uphold the tenets of our marriage for as long as I live. It's truly the honor of my life to be able to finally call you my wife. I love you so much. Oh my God. Wow. Yeah, it's beautiful. Thank you both for sharing those heartfelt vows. The rings that you are about to place on each other's fingers are symbols of the love that you've just expressed. They will remind you of the vows that you have just spoken and of the love that you have for one another. Chelsea and Nathan, remember this moment. As you place these rings on one another's finger, repeat after me. You're going first, right? This ring symbolizes my love for you.
This ring symbolizes my love for you.
Nathan.
Nathan.
And the commitments we made to each other today.
And the commitments we made to each other today.
Ready?
Yeah.
All right.
Let's do it.
This ring symbolizes my love for you, Chelsea.
This ring symbolizes my love for you, Chelsea.
And the commitments we made to each other today.
And the commitments we made to each other today.
Backwards. We're good?
Yeah.
Excellent. By the power vested in me by the state of Illinois, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Mr. and Mrs. Hokanson. Take your mom down there.
It went by so fast, oh my gosh. I love you.
There was one moment you looked at me and you started getting
Oh, I know. I was like, is she gonna lose it? I know, I was trying to get
I almost grabbed
it. Thank you so much for being there. You mean so much to both of us. Thank you so much.
Congrats.
Thank you.
Excited to celebrate.
Oh my gosh, thank you. Thank you for being with us.
Yeah.
Thank you. Really, thank you for being here with us. You mean so much to both of us. Buddy. Yeah.
It's a beautiful ceremony. Hey,
thank you, Neil. Thank you. Could have said a little more, but. Happy to be there for you. Happy you could be there for me.
I love you, man.
I love you too, man.
Congratulations.
Yeah. Hi.
Congratulations.
Thank
that
you.
Was beautiful.
Thank
here
you.
They are.
Thank you for welcoming us into the family so warmly. Oh, excited to be here.
This is pretty
rad. Nice. So happy to be part of your family.
Oh, you're part of our family. And you're
finally
family.
We finally are.
Oh, man, those smiles.
Oh, you both did okay. Yeah. Yeah.
You should be so happy. What a beautiful ceremony. So you nice. Have to look at yeah. Oh my gosh.
That's okay.
Hey, bro. I'm trying to get you up here.
Well, yeah, there's other people. Yeah.
I know.
Boy.
Yeah. All right. That's it.
So happy to be joining your family.
Oh, mm-hmm. We love to have you in the family.
I love
for the
you
first
all.
Time we met you, remember?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah,
thank you.
Beautiful.
I'm happy it's finally official.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you for being here.
Good work.
Thank you. Thank you, Grandpa.
Get that. Will you get that?
Turn around.
Oh. Hi, tissues.
It'll try.
Yeah.
I'm good.
Here you go.
We have more.
Woo!
Okay. Hi. Church mice. That's what we're being, church mice.
All of us. Anybody want to do over? Everybody happy with it? Yeah. We're all good?
I don't know. Have a good practice.
Okay. Yeah. All right, so next week is the real thing. So, yeah.
Wait a minute. Oh, yeah. Hang on.